न्यूमेरिकल्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स। सी पॉइंट नंबर वन, इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स इज ई वेक्टर डॉट ए वेक्टर, व्हिच इज रिटन एज ई ए कॉस थीटा, एंड दिस एरिया वेक्टर रिटन एज मॉड ऑफ एरिया वेक्टर इनटू एन कैप। दिस एन कैप कॉल्ड डायरेक्शन ऑफ एरिया वेक्टर, विच इज फाउंड आउटवर्ड ड्रॉन नॉर्मल टू गिवन एरिया और गिवन सरफेस। इट इज आउटवर्ड नॉर्मल एन कैप, इट गिव राइज टू डायरेक्शन ऑफ एरिया वेक्टर, देन इट इज डॉट प्रोडक्ट, एंड व्हेन यू ओपन इट इज ई ए कॉस थीटा। नाउ ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस फॉर्मूला वी विल सी न्यूमेरिकल्स। नाउ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इज व्हाट इज दिस थीटा। दिस थीटा इज द एंगल बिटवीन दोज टू वेक्टर्स हैविंग डॉट प्रोडक्ट और क्रॉस प्रोडक्ट इन बिटवीन देम, like dot product existing between E vector and A vector. So this theta is the angle between E vector and area vector. Breathe in. This area vector is mod of A vector into n cap. So direction of area vector is this n cap. So we can write the same thing. Theta is the angle between E vector and A vector. So we are writing it E vector and n cap, because this n cap gives direction of A vector. So we will focus what is the angle between E vector and n cap. Breathe in slowly and gradually. See, if I say this is the area area 1 and this is the area 2 and this is the direction of electric field. Breathe in slowly and gradually. I repeat, theta is the angle between E vector and n cap. See, this is the direction of electric field. So we are focusing on area 1. So what is the direction of area 1 vector? Outward drawn normal. See, it is normal to area 1 as well as it is outward. It is n1 cap. This n1 cap is the direction of area 1 vector. See, they are in opposite directions. So I will say angle between n1 cap and E vector is 180. So we call it theta 1. If I say theta 1 is the angle between E vector and n1 cap, see, they are in opposite. Similarly, for A2, this is outward normal, n2 cap. See, electric field left to right given to you, this electric field is in same direction of n2 cap, because it is outward normal. For A2, it is the direction of area 2. Now focus, this n2 cap and E vector are in same direction. So theta 2 will be 0 degrees. It is the angle between E vector and n2 cap. Breathe in again. Now see this area 3. What will be the direction of area 3? Outward normal. See, it is in the out of the cube, not inside, out. And perpendicular to that, A3, this is N3 cap. See, this N3 cap is in upward direction, making an angle of 90 degree with E vector. So we will say theta 3, it is 90 degrees. Similarly, you will see theta 4, theta 5, theta 6, all are 90 degrees. See how? You see electric field coming from left to right. See this direction of electric field, it is like this. This is N1 cap, outward normal, opposite of electric field. This is N2 cap, in the same direction of electric field. This is N3 cap. See, electric field from your left to right. So it is perpendicular to that. Similarly, A4. For this electric field, again it is perpendicular. See this one. For fifth surface, this is N5. Electric field is left to right, 90 degrees. Angle we are finding between E vector and N cap. This is N6. Perpendicular to sixth area. N6, now this is E vector, again perpendicular. Breathe in again. Actually these angles, theta 3, see this is area 4. See this is N4, this is perpendicular to E vector. Theta 3, theta 4, theta 5, theta 6, all are perpendicular to this diagram, this direction of electric field given to you. So this theta is the angle between E vector and A vector, means theta is the angle between E vector and N1, N cap. N cap is the direction of area vector. Breathe in. Now see, if you are given area inclined at an angle of 60 degrees with respect to direction of electric field of certain value, find electric flux, and let us say area is given 1 meter square. See, this is the area. And you are given area making an angle. Area and electric field. This is area, this sheet. And this is electric field direction. So this area inclined at an angle of 60 degrees. But you know, for finding flux, we need to find angle between E vector and N cap. N cap is normal to area. See, this is perpendicular, normal drawn to area. This is N cap. Breathe in slowly and gradually. Focus on this theta first. We are concerned about that angle which is in between E vector and N cap. Now focus on this line. Then focus, what is E vector? This is E vector. Next, is that N cap given to you? No, you are given area. So for given area, draw perpendicular line. It will give rise to N cap. And see, we require this. This is theta. Angle between N cap and E vector. So you see theta will be 90 minus 60. It will be 30 degrees. So for solving this numerical, you will input 30 degrees. Breathe in again. Same thing can be explained like this also. You know, this is plane of the area. Focus, this is plane of the area. And outward drawn normal. See, focus, this is outward drawn normal, perpendicular to area. On the paper, we show it like this, N cap. Perpendicular to area. Really speaking, it is this one. Now, electric field, let us say, applied like this. See, this is electric field and this is normal. So, two angles are visible. One, which is our required angle, theta. this is theta angle between n cap and E vector, or angle between E vector and n cap. And focus, one more angle is visible, this one. This is alpha. This is the angle between plane of area and E vector. So in this numerical, plane of area making an angle of 60 degrees. So that alpha was given. But we require this theta. So see, this is 90. Theta plus alpha is 90. We require theta. So it will be 90 minus alpha. Breathe in. Now see this question. Find electric flux linked with each surface of hollow cylinder as shown in the diagram. See, this is surface 1, surface 2, surface 3, having radius r, length l, and this direction of uniform electric field given to you, and this data is also given. Let us say radius is 10 centimeter, so change in into meters, and length is given 100 centimeter, that is 1 meter. Now in this question we are finding electric flux with each surface. Breathe in. You know flux. Flux is EA cos theta. Flux is EA cos theta. Now what is the concept? Answer is, if you are finding flux with surface 1, now focus on surface 1, then E1 is the field linked with surface 1, and surface 1 having area 1, then theta 1. I'm explaining, this E1 is the electric field linked with surface 1, and E2 is the electric field linked or passing through surface 2, and E3 is the electric field linked with area 3. So we write it like this. Phi 1 is E1 A1 cos theta 1. Phi 2 is E2 A2 cos theta 2. Phi 3 is E3 A3 cos theta 3. Now this is the numerical of uniform electric field. You know, uniform electric field means electric field is constant in magnitude and direction everywhere in the given region. If this is E electric field, it is same over here and each and every point in the given region. It means this E1, E2, E3, they all are equal and equal to E. So no need to write E1, E2, E3. But the concept is E1 should be the field passing through area 1. So I am writing this E1. Of course it is uniform electric field numerical. So in place of E1, it can be written as E. In place of E2, we will write again E. In place of E3, we can write E. You can write it directly. EA1 cos theta 1. EA2 cos theta 2. EA3 cos theta 3. But remember, we should write E1. E1 is the field passing through area 1. That decides flux linked with the area 1. Breathe in again. See, if we are finding flux with the area 1, we should write electric field passing through area 1, which is E in each and every case. So what is area 1? You know, area 1 is pi r square. Area 2 is curvature, 2 pi r. Area 3 is again circular, pi r square. Now what is theta 1? Theta 1 is the angle between E1 vector and A1. See, I am writing it. Theta 1 is the angle between E vector and A1. A1 means N1 cap, and E1 vector is nothing but E. For this numerical, this is the electric field direction for all the three cases. So draw outward normal. Outward normal for S1, it is N1 cap. It is direction of area 1, it is N1 cap. Similarly for S2, it is N2 cap, outward normal. For third, it is outward normal, N3 cap. See, this N1 cap is in opposite direction of E vector. So theta 1 will be 180 degrees. Theta 1 is the angle between E vector and N1 cap. Precisely, it is E1. So E1 matches with E, since it is uniform field. So we may write between E vector and N1 cap. Breathe in again. So since they are in opposite direction, we will write cos 180 degrees. Similarly, theta 2. Theta 2 is the angle between E vector and N2. See, this is E vector, this is N2, perpendicular. So theta 2 will be 90 degrees. N2 in upward direction, electric field left to right. And for this electric field passing through area 3, both are in same direction, E vector and N3 cap. So theta 3 will be 0 degrees. So put in the values cos theta 2, theta 2 90, theta 3 0 degree. You know cos 180 is minus 1. So it is minus E pi r square. You may write the units, Newton meter square per coulomb. It is 0. Cos 0 is plus 1, it is positive flux, E into pi r square Newton meter square per coulomb. See, this is inward flux for the area 1, entering the area. For this area 1, it is negative. See this electric field outward from S3, it is positive. Are you getting it? Positive flux, outward flux taken as positive. Classical definition of flux, inward flux taken as negative. And you know, if it is required, find total flux linked with the hollow cylinder. You know, flux is a scalar quantity. Just add them, phi1 plus phi2 plus phi3. See, one is negative and another is positive with equal amount. So total flux will be zero in uniform electric field. In uniform electric field, same number of lines are entering the closed area as well as leaving the closed area from classical definition. For uniform field, total flux with the closed area remains zero. This is the numerical part. Breathe in again. Now, this is homework. Okay, two homeworks. This is the direction of electric field, uniform electric field. And in this numerical, this is the direction of uniform electric field. Find electric flux with each surface 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So first of all, find direction of normals. Outward normal of S1, S2, S3 and S4. Similarly, find outward normal for this same diagram. So you see same normals, N1 cap, N2 cap, outward from area 2, outward normal for third area. Now this is for fourth area. Breathe in again. Now you know theta. You know theta is the angle between E vector and N cap. Here uniform electric field is given. So for uniform field, this will be the direction of electric field taken, whatever given to you. Only one direction, because it is not changing in magnitude and direction. These are two numericals. So if you are finding theta 1, it will be the angle between E vector and N1 cap. They are in opposite. So 180. So they are in same direction. Like in the previous cases, So E vector making 90 degree angle with this. Similarly, theta 4, theta 5, theta 6, 90 degrees. Now focus, this is downward electric field. They are in opposite direction. So here theta 3 will be 180, opposite. See, this is in upward direction. N3 cap. And electric field is in downward direction. See, in downward direction of electric field is in the same direction of N4. Theta 4, 0 degree. It is perpendicular to N2. So theta 2, 90. Perpendicular to N1, theta 1, 90. So you should focus, what is the direction of electric field given to you? Is it in downward direction, left to right, or some other way? Breathe in again. Now see, most important numericals for non-uniform electric field. Find electric flux with the surface 1 and surface 2 when electric field is 10x Newton per coulomb, where x is x coordinate or x is the distance from origin. Focus this diagram within the question you are given. And direction of electric field also given to you like this. This is area 1 given, area 2. This is cube of side 1 meter. And this is origin and this distance is given 2 meters up to surface 1. Now as per the reference plane in the diagram, it is given like this. Up to this S1. This is S1. Now this is the question only. Breathe in, answer. You know, if you are finding phi 1, it is E1, A1, cos theta 1. And if you are finding phi 2, it will be E2, A2, cos theta 2. Focus 100%. First of all, focus on this. This is called non-uniform electric field. See, it is given 10x. This equation tells us this electric field depending upon x. When x will be 0, E will be 0. When x will be 1 meters, E will be 10 into 1. 10 Newton per coulomb. When x will be 2 meters, 2, 10 into 2. E will be 20 Newton per coulomb. On changing x, E is changing. That is called non-uniform. Magnitude is variable. Direction is given left to right. Let us say x is 3 meter. So E will be 3 into 10, 30 Newton per coulomb. Breathe in. This calculation signifies when x is 0, field is 0. At 1 meter it is 10. At 2 meter value it is 20. Then it is 30. You know, which field should be taken? Breathe in slowly and gradually. See the concept. This E1 is the electric field passing through area 1. Wherever area 1 given to you, E1 should be linked with area 1. It should be passing through area 1. It should be, what will be the exact value of E1 at the position of S1? That is called linked with A1. Electric field linked with area 1 or S1. Breathe in. The next point comes into play. Where is area 1? Focus. area 1 at x1 distance away from origin. Focus in the diagram. See, whatever data given to us, it is one thing. First of all, see this concept. Where is area 1? Area 1 at a distance x1 from origin. This is origin, this is area 1. So this distance is x1. Where is area 1? At a distance x1 from origin. Breathe in. Similarly, where is area 2? Area 2 at x2 distance away from origin. So we are locating area 2. This is area 2 or S2. So where is this? This is the location. Area 2. So this is area 2 on the plane. So from origin at a distance x2, area 2 is visible. Breathe in again. First of all, decide as per the given origin, as per the given diagram, where is area 1? X1 distance away from origin. Where is area 2? X2 distance away from origin. Now, inputting the value of x1 will give rise to e1. E1 which is linked with area 1. Now see in the equation given. If I put E1 here. If I want to find E1, I will have to write X1. Because X1 distance away, E1 is the field which is linked with area 1. Similarly, I will have to see E2. See, if I am finding E2, I will have to write X2, 10 into X2. Now, as per the given question, what is X1 given to us? See, as per the given question, with reference to O, area 1, 2 meters away. So, X1 is 2 meter. Now, where is area 2? As per the given question, 2 meter plus C, this is from this portion to this. This is given length, which is 1 meter. So this is 1 meter given to us. So 2 plus 1, 3 meters. X2 is 3 meter. Now this is as per the data given. This is given to me within the question. It is 2 meter from origin to S1. And again it is 1 meter cube. So area 2 will be 2 plus 1, 3 meters away. Breathe in again. So if I put X1 as 2 meter, so E1 will be 20 newton per coulomb. So what is X2? 3 meters. So E2 will be 30 newton per coulomb. Now you put the values. You know E1 is 20 newton per coulomb. Area 1, it is very simple. Area 1, area 2, it's a cube, L square, 1 meter square, it is 1 meter square. So it is 1, theta 1, you know theta 1. Theta 1 is the angle between this direction of electric field and area 1 vector, n1 cap. So outward drawn normal for this area 1. Focus, you must know the previous lectures. This is n1 cap, outward drawn normal. This is E vector, both are in opposite directions. So theta 1, 180 degrees. So this is 180 degrees. This is 1 meter square. Solve it. This phi 1 will be 20 with the minus sign. And you know the units, newton meter square per coulomb. Similarly, E2. E2 is the electric field linked with area 2. And where is area 2? At a distance x2. So this E2 is 30 newton per coulomb. A2 is 1 meter square. And theta 2 will be 0 degree. How? Outward drawn normal for second surface, it is n2 cap. It is in the same direction of electric field vector. So both are in same directions. So theta 2 will be 0 degrees. So cos 0 plus 1, it is plus 30 Newton meter square per coulomb. This is non-uniform electric field. See, what are the points? Number 1, this electric field is variable. It is 20 Newton per coulomb at the position of area 1. Its value is 30 Newton per coulomb at the position of area 2. So we need to find E1 and E2. And for finding E1 and E2, we need to find X1 and X2. X1 is the distance of area 1 from origin, and X2 is the distance of area 2 from origin. Breathe in again. You know these normals, outward normal for S1, N1 cap, outward normal for S2, N2 cap. Now theta is the angle between E1 vector, direction is same, so in the same direction this opposite to N1, 180 degrees. Now this E vector in same direction of N2 cap, so theta 2 is 0 degrees. See another numerical, breathe in again. See, you are given like this. This time you know the answers. So listen it carefully. You will see very easy now. This is the direction of electric field. Number one. This is S1, S2. Outward drawn normal. N1 cap and N2 cap. See, they are in opposite directions. So theta 1, 180. E vector is in same direction of N2. Theta 2, 0 degrees. It's a cube of side L given to you. Origin given. And surface 1 given at a distance of A. And electric field is given alpha into x raised to the power 3 by 2. Newton per coulomb, where alpha is a constant and given 10 units. Units means you may manage the units with respect to this formula, or this will be given. So E is given actually 10 x raised to the power 3 by 2 Newton per coulomb. Breathe in again. So we are finding phi 1, which is E1 A1 cos theta 1. And we are finding phi 2, E2, A2, cos theta 2. So, want to find E1, which is linked with S1. Similarly, we want to find E2, which is linked with S2. So, question comes, how will you find E1? By inputting the value of X1. And by inputting the value of X2. So, what is X1? What is X2? X1 is the distance of area 1 from origin. So from origin, this is X1. This is area 1 location. Making sense? And this is location of area 2. X2 is the distance of area 2 from origin. Now in the previous numerical, X1 was 2 meters and X3 was 2 plus 1, 3 meters. Now in this numerical, you are not given in meters. You are given X1 is A. So no problem. What is given? Just input. X1 is A. So E1 is 10, A raised to the power 3 by 2. Now see, this is the length of the cube. And that is not given. So it is written L, length of the cube. Now focus, in this numerical, this X2 will be A plus L. No problem. Just write X2 is A plus L. In the previous numerical, it was 2 plus 1, 3 meters. In this numerical, you are not given the actual data. You are given in terms of A and L. So put in the terms of A and L. So input E1. You know A1, A2 is L square each because it is cube. See E1, E2, now these are the values. Theta 1, theta 2 known to you. A1, A2 known to you. Solve it and write in units Newton meter square per coulomb. Got it? Breathe in again. Now see in this, in the same numerical, if I shift this origin, focus. If I shift this origin and up to here, focus again. I'm shifting this origin to this location. Then you will see x1 becomes 0. This is the next numerical. See, it is most important numerical again. Same question, find phi1 and phi2 and cube of length 10 cm is given and electric field is given 10x plus 5 Newton per coulomb. And this is the diagram, focus 100%. Now origin is given this. And this is S1, S2. Now see, earlier origin was at this location and this was the distance x1. Now we are shifting origin at the location of s1. So you will have to have understanding s1 at origin is given. This is s1. This is the location of s1. This is the location of s2. See this. The rest is above the plane. This is, you know, three-dimensional diagram. So this S1 at origin means X1 is 0. And see, it's a cube of side L. So this distance is length of the cube and X2 will be L. This is main point. Breathe in. S1 at origin or origin fixed at S1. So X1 is 0. And S2 L distance away from origin. So this is X2. Are you getting it? S1 at origin. This is origin. So X1 will be 0. This first main point. Breathe in. Now see this E. So from this formula you will see E1 is 10 X1 plus 5. X1 is 0. So 0 plus 5, E1 is 5 Newton per coulomb. Focus, second main point. This length is given in centimeters. And you know, electric field given in Newton per coulomb. So in hurry, you may have some mistake. So be relaxed, breathe in slowly and gradually again. See, this is in Newton per coulomb and length given in centimeters. So change it in meters, 1 by 10 meter, move in fraction, it is easier. Now input the value of x, 10 into 1 by 10 plus 5, Newton per coulomb. Again, focus, this 10 cancel with 10, 1 will remain, 1 plus 5. So it will be 6 Newton per coulomb. This is another point to be remembered. Breathe in again, rest you know. How to solve? See, step number one, where is S1? Where is surface 1? At origin. Well, at origin, X1 will be 0. So we are finding E1 from the given equation. This time, this equation is given to us. He may give any equation. Just put in the value of X1, E1. Then find X2, E2. This is E2. While we are putting it X2, right? Then third point, phi1, input the values of E1, area 1, area 2. You know area 1 is, area 2 it is L square. Again it is in centimeter. So write it like this, 1 by 10 meter whole square, 1 by 100 meter square. Focus, another point. Then theta 1, theta 2. You know outward drawn normals for area 1. It is N1 cap and it will be N2 cap. Now theta 1. Theta 1 is the angle between E1 and A1. E1 and N1. So they are in opposite directions. So theta 1 will be 180 degrees and it is in same direction of N2. Theta 2 will be 0 degrees. Breathe in again. Now see another numerical. For a long hollow cylinder, you are given this diagram or statement is given of radius and fix origin at midpoint. See, statement may be given sometimes. And diagram will be given in some numericals. Now he says two electric fields are existing. Within hollow cylinder, first of value 100 Newton per coulomb in positive x direction and another of value 50 Newton per coulomb in negative x direction. He may write it like this, 100 I cap and minus 50 I cap. See, two electric fields are given. One, this is origin, focus on origin. With reference to this origin, fix origin at midpoint. Then in the positive x direction, this is electric field of 100 Newton per coulomb. Then in the negative x direction, 50. Negative means right to left as per origin given. Focus on origin. From origin, it is positive x direction. And for this origin, negative x direction. Now the question is, find electric flux with circular faces. Breathe in. Now, this can be given like in statement wise or in the diagram form. Answer. For answer, you will make the diagram. If diagram is not given, then you will consider, let us say, it is surface 1 and it is surface 2. Focus 100%. Draw normals. Normals to area 1. Focus 100%. This is normal to area 1. N1 cap. This is outward drawn normal to area 2 or S2. It is N2 cap. Now what is the concept? Finding flux with the surface 1. E1, A1, cos theta 1. Focus. What is E1? E1 is the electric field linked with or passing through area 1. Breathe in. Focus. Which field passing through area 1? Is it 50 or 100 Newton per coulomb? So you will see 50 Newton per coulomb is the electric field passing through area 1. So for this diagram, this is the E1 vector, which is right to left. See, this is E1 vector. So which electric field is E1? Which is passing through area 1. So it is 50 Newton per coulomb. Again breathe in. What is theta 1? Now theta 1 is the angle between E1 and A1. See, this is E1. This is A1. A1 means N1. Both are in same directions. So theta 1 will be 0 degrees. So you will solve it. It will be A1 pi r square and it will be cos 0 degrees. You can solve it. And units, Newton meter square per coulomb. Breathe in again. Now want to find flux with second. Phi 2, E2, A2, cos theta 2. Again, what is E2? E2 is the electric field passing through area 2. See, this is area 2, S2. This 100 Newton per coulomb passing through area 2. So this is E2. Focus. E2 is the electric field passing through S2 or area 2. So what will be theta 2? Theta 2 will be the angle between E2 vector and A2. A2 means N2. N2 cap is the direction of A2 vector. Now you see, again they are in same direction. See, this is electric field E2. This is N2. Again they are in same direction. E vector left to right, N2 left to right. So theta 2 will be 0 degrees. Now input the values of these. This will be 0 degrees and E2 is 100. Now you simplify and you will be writing units. Newton meter square per coulomb. This is called, you know, non-uniform electric field example. Two different electric fields are given having two different values as well as different directions. So you should focus what is the direction of field passing through area 1 and the normal to area. See the angle between them. Got it?